So that was, of course, Grace Kelly by Mika. And lucky of me, he joins me in the green room right now. Hello.
Hello.
How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm really good. I get huge memories every time I hear that song, because we play it still quite a bit on Magic, of that amazing circus-themed party that you and your record label put on Berkeley Square in London.
We put up a circus tent in the middle of Berkeley Square and we launched everything that was right at the beginning.
I know. It doesn't feel like 2007, though. It doesn't feel like that long. To you, does it?
It does. I mean, well, only because I've been touring non-stop, you know, and life kind of, you know, personal life catches up with work life eventually, but it's always slightly behind. It's never really ahead, I've noticed. And so that gives it, you know, I see my life in terms of quite defined chapters. Every time I put out an album, it's another chapter. And especially the last few years of my life have been so mad and so funny that I could never have predicted. If you asked me 10 years ago, and I was at college, what my life would be like in 10 years' time, and you kind of describe this, I would just find it funny.
Yeah.
I think it was mad.
I mean, I want to talk to you about what you've been up to, but that chapter of your life when you first sort of came with your album Cartoon Motion, how do you remember it? Because for me as a presenter and a journalist, all I remember is that you were just, everyone wanted to talk about you. Everyone was trying to decide who you were, put labels on you. Yeah. It was all about like, who is Mika? What are
who
you?
Who is Mika? What is Mika?
Yeah.
It's just kind of, it's what happens. And I think that if anyone, you know, in this business, it's just, you have to really be strong. You have to be really not kind of feel like you have to answer every question. Just take your time. Let life take its course. It's a strange thing because you write songs in your bedroom, you write songs in your living room. Of course, you have delusions of grandeur, but they're just delusions. You don't ever believe that one day those records will actually go really far and you'll be kind of chasing after them and touring and stuff. But I'm grateful for it enormously.
So let's talk about what else you've been up to, because you've been doing a lot of TV, haven't you?
I have.
Been a judge on The X Factor in Italy.
Yeah.
Simon Cowell is now a huge fan, I hear.
He is, he loves it.
Because at first he was like, I remember there was a bit of a, you know, Simon was like, I'm not sure I understand Mika in his sort of Simon Cowell way. And now he thinks you're ace.
Yeah, he loves it. And he's a huge supporter. And I think he's been looking at what we've done in X Factor in Italy and trying to kind of like do something along the same energy in the UK. And he's quite open about it. I think what they're doing in the UK is brilliant. I think the direction they're going in as well is brilliant. It makes it, people can relate to it. Just a bit everywhere, you know, like it's not panto.
Yeah.
It could be kind of like real again.
Yeah, which it has become
a little bit
panto.
It's a little bit of pantomime. It's very easy for something like that to happen. But I think it's good. It's playing itself out really well. But the thing is, though, I do the voice as well, which also infuriates Simon, because I do the voice in France.
Yeah, how?
At the same time as doing
X Factor
in Italy. So that side of it is he's less pleased about. But then again, that's quite fun.
Well, exactly, and it's quite fun to wind Simon up sometimes. So has he asked for your advice then on this year's
advice? No, not really. But he's been observing a lot what was going on, and I think, you know, there's this thing in Italy, like they sing everything from, like, there's people who, like, when we choose songs, we can choose things from Michael Jackson, of course, but to the Cardigans, to Gossip, you know, to songs from The Gossip, to, like, you know, Harry Nilsson, to Beatles, like this really open, this rich thing, which means that whatever the particular kind of slant that one singer has, it can really be exaggerated, which means you get really defined personalities and characters that and storylines that are really established. Because, you know, when you don't have the full freedom to choose any songs you want, it's hard because you lose the story of the person, because you have someone who should never be singing a song, they're singing that song.
The judges moan that they hear the same songs all the time. And it's like, well, because there's only a certain
But I think that's going to change. Yeah. I think there's a dynamism, you know, that's being infused into it, which is really good.
Mika, it's really lovely to see you, to catch
it's
up.
Good to see you too.
You look exactly the same.
It's been a long time.
I don't look exactly the same. You look exactly the same. You haven't aged. What's your secret?
That's not true. I haven't slept in weeks.
Why? Just because you've been working?
Well, yeah, I've just been working a lot. I just came back from touring Asia. But it's... I think I feel very free. I feel I'm having a lot of fun. The one thing I really do want, though, is with all this stuff that I've been doing, I want to come back more to the UK. I still live here, but I don't spend much time here. But I want to work more in the UK. I want to tour more in the UK, and it's a part of my life. It's, you know, 24 years of your life when you're only 31. It's like, you know, it's just, it feels really good to be here having this conversation and talk about new music.